I'm Dr. Mark Darner, board certified chiropractic neurologist. Today we'd like to talk about Mother, also a methylfolate tetrahydrofolate reductase gene mutation. So let's go through it and see what we've got here. So what we have with Mother, typically MFTHR, is a gene mutation that presents to the clinic in a very specific fashion. So we have a patient come in, and the diversity of symptoms can be broad. We could have neuropathy, we could have behavioral disorder, but the first thing I notice about Mother potential patients are that they're generally women. When they present, they have a certain body shape. It's like a pear shape. You can tell they're a little bit overweight. And then they present with a demure, reserved, or very extroverted personality type. So we get the two type, think the mousy librarian female, or think the extroverted, flamboyant casino stripper, or something like that. So they may have lots of facial metal, they may have half their head shaved, three hair colors, very extroverted, or the other way, just kind of like a mousy reserved librarian. And they have a body shape, it's a pear shape when they come in, and they'll present with whatever they're describing. So I want to show that when you're doing the exam, whether it's I think I have carpal tunnel syndrome, or I get headaches, or it seems like I maybe have blood clotting or numbness and tingling in my hands and feet, while you're doing the exam, the patient will demonstrate this type of reserved, demure, or hyper extroverted persona. And then we get to the, let's do the list. Let's do the list of what does Mother look like? And the purpose to this video is you've either been sent here to review for spouse and family what is Mother, treatment for it, or its presentation. So let's do a list, and we'll review and we'll see how it turns out. So they generally have a pear shape. They are generally behavior extreme, either demure or they're extroverted. They have, generally they're in their 30s, which is kind of interesting. And it's interesting why that occurs. They're generally female, and they're presenting to the office, let's call it 35 to 42 years old would be the typical window. Occasionally I see them a bit younger. And I'm more detecting the extroverted type because they're drawing attention to the Mother disorder. So what this is it's a gene disorder of folate metabolism. And the folate metabolism doesn't allow certain functions within the liver and within the brain. So we get a certain type of behavior, and then we have a certain type of metabolism change that fosters these symptom presentations. So they've got the pear shape, the demure, they're female, and then they're going to have a dowager. And I'm not sure if I'm spelling right, but a lady hump, a dowager's hump. It's right here on the back of the neck, and they'll have a fat pad, which is a brown fat pad that might be typically seen in an aging 60, 70-year-old. But here you have a 35-year-old with a fat pad, and they're overweight. They have a pear shape. So I should say right there, overweight. And then when you get into questioning out what is Mother with them, you know, Mary, let me describe something. I think you may be potentially a candidate for Mother. So what is Mother? Mother is a metabolic disorder of the reductase, methylfolate reductase enzyme, and it prevents certain metabolic functions in the liver and in the brain, and it presents as a pear-shaped body type, highly resistant to fat loss, so these people have tried like crazy to lose weight, a dowager's formation in the back of the neck, a demure or hyper-extreme extroverted personality type. They're presenting with a multitude of neuropathies or metabolic, sometimes an autoimmune presentation. And then they'll say things like, you know, they'll demonstrate and say things like, I'm depressed, or I have malaise and I'm not happy with life. I'm at my wit's end, I've seen 20 doctors and I don't know what's going on. I'm just like my grandma. And now they mention something inheritable or hereditary, and this gene disorder is a genetic disorder. So they did get it as a combination of alleles from their family tree. And I may do a few feature video that demonstrates from grandma, great-grandma down through father, and how the alleles line up to become both recessive 677 or 1298 versions. So the 677 version and the 1298 version are a little bit different. They affect the folate metabolism cycle in a different area, and that area manifests itself a little differently in the brain and in the liver. So we get interruption of the methionine folate interaction loops, and it presents a fatigued, tired, overweight female, usually female, sometimes male, with a Dowager's hump. And the interesting thing about 1298 is it has a bit of kink. And I don't ask the patients exactly what it is, what's their kink, but when I say it, I will just say, and Mary, this particular disorder has a bit of kink. And they'll, oh, you can see it? No, I can't see your kink, but you know what it is? Yeah, okay. And I don't need to know what it is, but it presents. On the hyper extroverted one, it's obvious. They frequently are overtly homosexual, or they have this behavioral, presentational behavior that's extreme. Shaved head, five colors in the hair, clothes that don't match, shoes that don't match, earrings that are, you know, crazy, crazy. And these people are not crazy. I use that just as an example on that they're very multicolored, and they're very flamboyant, very Liberace. And it doesn't matter male or female, this has been the pattern that I've seen since observing mother and being trained as a functional neurologist. So we go through the typical examination process for what they presented for neuropathy typically, or metabolic disease that looks like autoimmunity. And then we get to, you know, you've made a pattern here. We have a pear shape. You're demure, extroverted, you're in the female right age group, you have a Dowager's formation at the wrong age, there's two versions to the mother disorder, you can have one or the other or both, the 1298 one has a bit of kink, oh yeah, I have that, okay, I understand. And there's also a long history of being either misdiagnosed or undiagnosed from many doctors. And this is not a secretly known or a rarely known condition, but generally doctors that are aware of it took some interest in nutritional disorders, non-metabolic, or disease processes that had parasite or infective source. It is a genetic disorder. So you get down to doctors that understand it, that have studied some nutrition, and then they'll will find it. So you have this presentation. You may talk with your physician about being tested for a mother. It's detected on a blood test. The blood test is not highly expensive. Some blood tests, like Cunningham panel, can run $1,000. This one does not. It might be $50, $60 in your area. So the blood test comes back positive. We have a 677 or a 1298 version on mother. Now the treatment is very simple. The treatment is methylated folate. So now we take methylated methylfolate, and we start taking an oral supplement for methylfolate, and Mary's life changes. The changes that occur are nutritional and metabolic occurring within the liver, and we're interceding on the abnormal metabolism of folate, metabolism liver and brain. So you get uptick in energy, you get an uptick in change in brain function. I feel better about life, I can laugh at the joke, the movie was so funny. That was not occurring before. And I've observed that it's about a 6 month to 1 year process for people to transition to their new metabolic native state or homeostatic stable set point. So they're taking 6 months to 1 year to normalize. And it's very interesting to see Mary no longer has kink, or it's not as intense. She has the ability to enjoy life. We get better serotonin and dopamine release in the brain, and we have a completely changed personality. And generally, when people's personalities change, they put life in order. So they get rid of their toxic relationships, they leave their abusive employer, and they start to have a more normal and happy life. And it's been through the clinician's observation of this pattern and then knowledge that you can do a blood test that identifies Mother, and if it's positive, it's treated with methylfolate. So I wanted to thank you for viewing the video. If you have somebody that matches this pattern, I would encourage you to speak to them about watching this video or contacting our office for more information for a consultation with me or a highly trained physician in their area. I'm Dr. Darner, board certified chiropractic neurologist. You can always visit us online at mynewspine.com. Have a great day.